Hey, good morning. Happy Sunday. We are so glad that you're able to join us in the Sunday morning for a brand new program we prepare for you. Let's bow our head and pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for gathering us here to worship you together. And Lord, we know that we are being attracted by your majesty to come before you and to bring honor to you. Lord, we know that the past year you protected us and gave us what we need to go through every day, and we are so thankful for it, and we had to count our blessings. At the same time, as we begin our new year, we continue to look upon you for your guidance and for your protection and for your teachings, so that we can live every day to the fullness. And also we would like to witness you in our everyday life. Teach us and help us. I know that we would like to be more like you. We would like to live a life that is matching the saving grace that you gave us for free. Lord, we know that it's not easy. We know that we may not be perfect, and we are definitely not perfect. We need a lot of help, but Lord, we know that we can count on you, and you, may you just accept our desire to live a life that is pleasing to you. Lord, once again, we come before you this morning, and through the songs and opening the Bible and our discussion, Lord, we like to bring honor and praises to you, and help us to dig deeper and let your word take root in our heart. And may you bless the time we spend together. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So good morning. Happy Sunday. Happy New Year too. Today is the first Sunday of 2021. Are you excited and also anticipating? It is great that we have another opportunity to worship the Lord together and open the Bible and see how we can apply these teachings in life. We will start a brand new study series in 2021 as preparation. Today, we want to take the time to remind you the importance of the Bible and see how the prophecies in the Bible confirm its unshakable status. So before we go into the scriptures and discussion, let's worship the Lord through a song. As we begin a new year, we anticipate and we dream big, and we can also get nervous and unsure at the same time. You may be going into the new year with a very clear roadmap and a well-planned detailed blueprint, or you are just still trying to figure out what you want to do, or taking a wait and see approach. This is exactly the moment we need to remember the greatness of our God. Nothing and no one will ever be greater than him. That gives us the assurance to trust him and leads us to sing praises to the mighty God. The title of the song is How Great Is Our God.
Our God. Today's scriptures reading is from 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 12 to 17. In fact, everyone who wants to live a godly life in Christ Jesus will be persecuted, while evildoers and impostors will go from bad to worse, deceiving and being deceived. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and have become convinced of, because you know those from whom you learned it, and how from infancy you have known the holy scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All scriptures is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, so that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work.
Hey, how's everyone? While we may be making plans for a new year, you and I can't predict how it will turn out and when things will really happen. Speaking of prediction, I came across an interesting experiment on how our answers to some simple questions can be predicted. First, I will show you the questions, then a video clip with the explanation will come next. The video clip will also feature a different challenge, so have fun with it.
Pay attention. This is the next step in retraining your brain. We need you to put the days of the week in alphabetical order, starting with Friday. You have 10 seconds. Ready? Go. How did you do? Pretty hard, huh? Here's the correct order. Now, quickly, without thinking about it, name a color. Got it? Now, name a tool. Did you just say red hammer? Did we just read your mind? Or come pretty close to it? It's freaky, right? Let's find out what other people said when we asked them to do the same thing.
As you can see here, we have the days of the week. I want you to put them in alphabetical order for me.
Okay.
If you struggled with this task, you're not the only one.
Monday, Thursday, Tuesday, Monday.
Friday, Thursday, easy. Friday,
great.
Monday, Saturday, Sunday, Thursday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Now, very quickly, give me a color and a tool.
A red hammer.
Oh, you know why it's so weird you said that?
What the?
Easy, fella. This is a family show. But this guy isn't the only one who said,
red hammer. No way. Shut the front door, a red hammer.
A red hammer. No way. Wow.
Red hammer.
Oh, I love that you said that. You know why?
What? That is crazy.
Insane, right?
Dude, that's crazy and nuts.
Out of all the colors and tools in the world to choose from, isn't it a little crazy? We knew a lot of people would say,
red hammer?
Red hammer.
Red hammer.
Of course, not everyone chose a red hammer.
Black hammer.
And some people got creative.
Pink screwdriver.
But if you're like 80% of those we tested, you also chose a red hammer.
How did you do that, man?
That's a good question. As it turns out, your brain has a secret system of shortcuts for how it stores information and ideas. We've asked NYU psychologist Scott Barry Kaufman to help us understand how it works.
Your brain stores information in general categories, like colors, tools, or furniture. And each category has its own best example. These examples help your brain quickly and efficiently find what it needs without having to dig through everything you know. For most people, the best example for colors is red, and the best example for tools is hammer.
Dude, you are freaking me out right now.
So did you say red hammer like everyone else did? The answer is predicted by understanding and analyzing things we already know. And in this case, how our brain works in general. And as you can see in the video though, people may come up with other combinations of colors and tools, and the red hammer prediction isn't 100% accurate. The Bible also told us things in advance, sometimes thousands of years ahead. They are called the prophecies, and they are not merely predictions. Predictions may or may not come true, as the one who predicts cannot have absolute control of the outcomes. On the other hand, the prophecies in the Bible will always be fulfilled because it is the words of God and everything is in God's hand. So please open your Bible and we will go through Revelation chapter 11, verse 3 to 10. I will have the scriptures on the screen with some music, and when we come back, we will have teacher Andrew and he will explain to us what a prophecy is about and why it is important.
Good morning and a happy new year. What a strange year 2020 has been. If you have asked a psychic in 2019 what 2020 would look like, he may have told you some scene that you cannot understand. He may say that he sees you wearing a mask, pushing a cart filled with water bottles and toilet papers. And he sees you went out at noontime, but you have trouble seeing because it was dark and everything looked orange in color. He sees that you are eating alone and somehow you missed the feast at Thanksgiving. Well, all these would not make any sense if you had heard them in 2019. However, we know exactly what it means when we are now in 2020. So, you and I live in an extraordinary time in the history of mankind. Never have changes happened so much in so little time. Now, many of the Bible's prophecy written more than 2,000 years ago could not be fully understood until now. We will study a passage today that would illustrate this point. Now, before we study the scripture, I want to point out that prophecy may be intriguing, but it is only a very small part of the Bible. We by nature are fascinated to hear from someone who can tell us our future. However, the Bible tells us not to seek this because no one can really control the future other than God himself. If the fortune teller tells you that you have a good future, you may feel good for a little bit, but you may doubt his ability. Now, if he tells you you have a cursed future, you may doubt his ability, but you will feel lousy forever. So this is a loose-loose situation. The purpose of prophecy in the Bible is to show us the power of God. Only his word are infallible. What God said is the truth, and if it had not happened yet, it will. Now, God tells us in advance so that when we see it happen, we will learn to trust in his words. Now, if there's a book in this world that tells you today what happens tomorrow, what do you think this book is worth? Do you think the people will want this book? If one can find out what the stock market does tomorrow, today, one can become very rich very fast. So people will kill to get their hand on this book. Yet, there is such a book on earth, the Bible. We do have a lot of copies sold throughout the world, yet people do not read the Bible as eagerly as they may read Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp posts. You figure. Today's scripture is from Revelation, written by Apostle John when he is old, almost 2,000 years ago. It is a book that is difficult to understand because John had to describe the future he is seeing with only the knowledge of his time, which is 2,000 years ago. Think about how much it has changed in the past 50 years. When I was your age, our top-of-the-line TV screen is black and white, maybe 12 inches. Electronics are non-existent. We learned to use the abacus at school. And a handheld calculator did not become available till I was in college. If I was able to see the future then, from 50 years ago, I would not be able to describe all the gadgets we have today. So today's scriptures come from Revelation chapter 11, verse 3 through 10. Verse 3 says, "And I," meaning God, "will grant authority to my two witnesses, and they will prophesy for 1260 days, clothed in sackcloth." Verse 4, "These are the two olive trees and the two lampstands that stand before the Lord of the earth." Now, these passages describe what has not happened yet today. 1260 days is the first half of the 7 year of tribulation, which will begin when Jesus Christ returns to collect the church. And since the church will not be on earth to witness for God, God sent these two witnesses to prophesy to the world. Verse 5, and if anyone wants to harm them, fire flows out of their mouths and devours their enemies. And so if anyone wants to harm them, he must be killed in this way. Verse 6, these have the power to shut up the sky so that rain will not fall during the days of their prophesying. And they have power over the waters to turn them into blood, to strike the earth with every plague as often as they desire. Imagine a world in such a chaos. There's no Christian on earth, and men who don't believe God must hate these two witnesses who's torturing them, and they must try to kill them. However, God gave them supernatural power. They could not be killed before it is time. Verse 7. When they have finished their testimony, the beast that comes out of the abyss will make war with them and overcome them and kill them. So only after the 3.5 years, when they have finished their work, were they killed by the beast, who is possibly Satan. So God's work cannot be stopped until it's completed. Verse 8, and their dead bodies will lie on the street of the great city, which spiritually is called Sodom and Egypt, where also their Lord was crucified. So what city was our Lord crucified? Jerusalem in Israel. Verse 9, those from peoples, tribes, languages, and nations will look at their dead body for 3.5 days and will not allow their dead bodies to lay in a tomb. Now, imagine this is 2,000 years ago. People of all nations would not even hear of what happened in Jerusalem for weeks or months. It takes so long just to get a message, even if they carry it by a fast horse. So, and they have no cameras to take pictures and send it so other people can see. Only nowadays, in this day and age, do we have the technologies for instant transmission over the satellite that all nations can see their dead bodies in Jerusalem. Verse 10, and those who live on earth will rejoice over them and celebrate, and they will send gifts to one another, because these two prophets tormented those who live on the earth. The people of the world celebrated by sending gifts to one another during this 3.5 days when they can see their dead body. Imagine. Only now do we have next day delivery from Amazon that it is even possible. So such is extraordinary time we have. So I hope you appreciate how valuable the Bible is. The entire book is God's word. It's all true. God controls even the future. He tells us the future so that when we see it happen, we will believe that all his words are true, even in our darkest hour and desperation. We will have hope because we can trust God's word. God's word will not fail. Next week, we will start a study new series on the Gospel of John. I hope you will be eager to know and learn God's word. Goodbye.
I hope today's lesson reinforces your understanding of the importance of the Bible. Prophecy may not be something you think of very often, or it is anywhere near your priority list. Well, however, when you understand how the Bible told us about these events thousands of years ahead and how these events eventually and accurately happened over time, you should have a better appreciation of the Bible and have to trust that it is God's words written for us. The prophecies and the fulfillments of these prophecies confirm the authority and power of the Bible, the words from God. That should give us the assurance that we can count on the Bible for its teachings and many more, and the incentives to read it, to study it, and to take it seriously. And prophecies may be fascinating, and they give you a glimpse of what is coming ahead for mankind. However, there is a lot more than prophecies in the Bible. There's a lot more we can focus on and learn and then apply to our life. There's so much treasure waiting for you in the Bible. And next week, we will unlock and open the treasure trove together with you and start a new study series based on the Gospel of John. So before we go, I would like to give you three questions to think about in the coming week. First, we talked about prophecies in today's Bible lesson. What other content can you find in the Bible? So flip through it and see if you know any of the different books and chapters in the Bible, and you know, think about what other content you can find in the Bible. So second question, do you want to know in advance how the future will turn out? Why and why not? So for this one, there's really no definitive answer, but I want you to think about it and not just say yes or no, but at the same time, think about the reason behind it, right? So question number three, is there anything you would like to accomplish in the new year? Anything that God can help you accomplish that you need help? So that's the third question. And we'd like to remind everyone to stay healthy, stay in touch, and stay with God. See you next Sunday at 9:30 a.m. And once again, Happy New Year. Stay safe, stay warm, and we'll see you again.